problems are not solved in a day. You have to get into it and you keep at it. It requires both passion and persistence. So I think anything that we do, I mean, if you look at what we did in the last 5 years, you know, we created the world's largest ID platform, and we have 56 crore people on the platform. We have created the world's largest cash transfer program, and we have given about 20 million people about 40 million cash transactions. We have enabled financial inclusion. So I think if you have major things that you can change, whether it's changing your educational system or changing healthcare system, I think you can bring this kind of thinking to it. We have to create an environment where more entrepreneurs can be successful. And, you know, to make entrepreneurs successful, I told you our own story. We started in 1981. It took us 12 years to go public. It would take us 2 years to get a phone. We had to go to the Reserve Bank for money every time we had to travel abroad. So these are all essentially, they are barriers to growing a business. And even today, young business people face these barriers.
I keep meeting young people from very humble backgrounds whose aspirations are of a very high order. They want to be scientists, they want to be doctors, they want to be engineers, they want to be astronauts. So I think we have reached a very sort of important point where, for the first time I think in Indian history, we have such a large number of people whose aspirations have been unleashed. And the thing about aspirations is that aspirations are non-linear. A child may be living in a, you know, 8x8 room in a slum, but he or she wants to be a doctor and engineer when their parents don't even have an education. The second thing is the sheer scale. Today, half the population in India is below 25, which means that we have more than 50 crore or 60 crore people, or 500 to 600 million people below the age of 25. Never again in history has India had, or any country for that matter, had so many young people at the same time. And I remember my days at IIT, most of the young men and women in my class were urban. They were from English-speaking schools in Delhi and Bombay. And it wasn't really a socially diverse mix. But today, the other day when I went to IIT, I found that each kid was from a very different location. There were a lot of kids from Patna, there were kids from who studied in Kota. So there's a huge demographic transition happening. And we have this huge young pool of people who want to really achieve huge things in life. So we have one, the largest pool of young people, more than half a billion people in the year 25. And second, you have unleashed these hyper aspirations. The third thing which is happening, which is also happening simultaneously, is impatience with those aspirations. Today, if I talk to a young entrepreneur, I was talking to a young entrepreneur the other day who's setting up a company, and he's talking about not only growing the company, but selling it in a couple of years. So everything is now happening in fast forward. So I think that's the other thing which is happening, which is that we grew up in an era of delayed gratification, but now it's all about quick feedback, quick consummation, and so forth. And I think this combination of aspirations, hyper aspirations, impatience, and a large pool of people is really the central challenge that we face today. And in some sense, everything that we see in our politics, the anger, the divisiveness, is basically because the instruments that we have of governance, the instruments of delivering education, the instruments of delivering public services, have simply not coped with this dramatic transformation that's happening on the ground. And this mismatch between people's aspirations and what needs to be done is really the central challenge that we seem to face. Unless we dramatically transform the ability to solve these issues at scale, we really will not be able to satisfy the aspirations of our people. And that's really, to me, the central issue of our time. Now, how does one deal with this? I think it requires us to therefore realize that the way we think of creating space for all these people is not by linear means. It's not about saying, you know, this year we have 10 colleges, next year we'll have 12 colleges, year after that we'll have 14 colleges, or this year we have literacy of 40%, next year we'll have 41%. It's really about thinking very differently about creating the opportunities at scale. And that's in some sense what I tried to do when we all set up the Aadhaar project. And the reason why it appealed to me was here was an opportunity to create change at scale. And this was a very important thing for us, because we wanted to do something that had meaningful impact in a very short period of time. So I see the central challenge of our governance is how do we make sure that we create opportunities at scale, at speed, and rethink the model. And I don't think the model is going to be found by being divisive in our politics. I don't think the model is going to be found by being angry about people. It's really about getting into the nitty-gritty. It's about getting into the trenches. It's about looking at systems through a very, very dispassionate lens to make sure that you're able to expand its scope and unleash the potential of our people and make sure that we have make sure that everybody has the opportunity. If we don't do that, then I think the consequences will go the other way. So that's my belief, and I think we owe it to our young people, we owe it to them to create a future where everybody has a chance, and that requires us to rethink everything we do. Thank you very much.